Welcome to the Dripping Pan, where Lewes FC have beaten the Albion 2-1 after extra time in an enthralling match in the Sussex Senior Cup. Let's take a look at some of the action. In the 19th minute, Brighton win a free kick in a dangerous area, but Ricky Banks saves comfortably from Starkey's shot on target. Just a few moments later, the referee has some stern words with Lewes assistant manager Danny Blore after what seemed to be a claim for a free kick. In the second half, Fenelon drives the ball forward from a Lewes throw and manages to sneak through the Rooks' defence. Wilshere is in the right place at the right time and his shot edges in off the post and past Banks. 1-0 to Brighton. Into the dying minutes of the match with the last kick, Lewes's Tom Davis scores the equaliser from a low free kick. 1-1. And just minutes into extra time, Tom Davis scores a worldie to give Lewes the lead in extra time. 2-1 to the Rooks. And that's how it stayed. After the match, we spoke to assistant manager from Lewes, Danny Blore. We also spoke to Nicky Wheeler and the goal scorer, Tom Davis. You left it late, didn't you? You scored in literally the last kick of the match. Talk us through how it was for you out there on the pitch.
Yeah, it was tough. We had a lot of chances sort of first half, especially myself. I'm guilty of not putting two away at least. But left it late. But then thankfully Tom scored a good free kick right at the end and sealed us into extra time. I didn't really have the legs for extra time in the end, but yeah, it was all right. I'm glad we got through it and then scored an absolute screamer at the end.
We've had a good run going, so we needed, as we said today, we're not going to lose the game, so we needed to keep the confidence high. It felt good because we've got a good formation going and the team seemed to know, everyone knows their jobs at the moment. We're quite organised. We've had a few injuries today, so the players that come on done well, and Nicky's done well when he come on wide. He's been itching at the jumping at the bit to try and get on and play get a few minutes in, and he needed that today. And when I scored the equaliser, I said to him, "Oh, you need them extra minutes for the extra time." And but yeah, we're pulling together. We've got a good structure now with the team, how we're playing and how we're set up. And yeah, I think we're going to go have a good run going now.
Going into your next match, you've got an FA Trophy game here at the Dripping Pan. How do you go into that match and obviously prepare for the next game?
Well, I think obviously you saw against Brighton's development side, we picked up a couple of what looks like nasty injuries. Lloyd Harrington's got a knee problem and Matt Crabb has gone to hospital with stitches. So I think it'd be firstly just doing a head count. And we picked up, obviously, Nicky Wheeler hadn't played for a while. Nathan Crabb hadn't played for a while. You know, there were some really tired bodies at the end, but I thought our boys' passion, spirit, commitment was fantastic. And it's a game now, you know, as I say, 4 unbeaten. We've got Heybridge Swifts at the Dripping Pan this Saturday in the FA Trophy. There's some prize money at stake, so it's a game we're all really looking forward to. And then also we want to move up the Ryman Premier League. We're out of that relegation zone after the excellent win at Leatherhead last Saturday. So onwards, upwards and forwards, and we're certainly enjoying the month of November.